JRA 501. LA Unified misspent millions marked for school lunches. At least 8 California school districts have misappropriated millions of dollars in funding intended to pay for meals for low-income students, the biggest culprit being the Los Angeles Unified School District, according to a state Senate watchdog group. The California Department of Education has ordered districts to repay more than $170 million in misused funds to their student meal programs, the California Senate Office of Oversight and Outcomes said in a report issued Wednesday. LA Unified has been forced to pay back more than $158 million in misappropriations and unrelated charges that the district made over 6 years, ending in 2011. Whoops, sorry. My mouse is running amok. State officials suspect the alleged misuse of funds could be more widespread across California school districts. In most cases, school systems attempted to use cafeteria funds to pay for personnel, utilities, and other expenses. Other school districts named in the report are Oxnard, San Diego, Santa Ana, San Francisco, Baldwin Park, Centinela Valley, and Compton. Oxnard was forced to repay $5.6 million. San Diego and Santa Ana are challenging the findings of the department, which has ordered them to pay $4.5 million and $2.7 million respectively. LA Unified redirected funding for years, ignoring reports from administrators and its own inspector general before an employee alerted state authorities, the survey said. Among other expenses, the district diverted funding to pay for sprinklers and salaries of employees at a district television station. So why did the administrators and the inspector general let this go on for years? Why? And why aren't these people that are running the Los Angeles Unified School District, why aren't they being fired? Why aren't the administrators being fired? Why isn't the inspector general being fired for not doing their jobs? LA Unified said in a statement that administrators have been working with the state to ensure compliance, and said the district looks forward to success with state education officials in this work to find a more rational approach to accounting and compliance guidelines for all schools statewide. I don't know why they would need to find a more rational approach to accounting. I mean, that is what the school districts do. That's their job. Federal regulations require districts to keep the student meal funding in an account to be used only for the improvement of food service. Most districts keep federal, state, and other cafeteria revenues in that same account, and all funds must comply with federal regulations. The report, however, found that the system to monitor the spending of those funds is overloaded and that regulations governing spending are too complex. School districts, as a result, have repeatedly disregarded the rules and subsequently contested violations as arguable interpretations of the law. How can you argue stealing money and taking food out of the mouths of babes? Oversight of these funds is carried out by 60 state examiners who monitor nearly 3,000 districts. They're nutritionists, but they have not completed all inspections required by law since 2001 and rarely take more than a cursory look at the books. So, this has been going on since 2001, and nobody has stepped up and said, hey, you guys are overworked. I mean, I failed math miserably, but it doesn't, you don't even have to know math to figure out that 60 examiners monitoring 3,000 districts is going to be a bit much. The diversion of funds often contributes to conditions that discourage eligible students from seeking free or reduced-priced meals. To maximize funds, districts have used cost-saving methods of serving processed rather than fresh foods, shortening the lunch periods, and cutting back on cafeteria maintenance and staff, all of which hinder student participation. Wow, if that's just not, I mean, that's just amazing. I can't even wrap my head around this one. So take the money that's allocated, give them a bunch of processed foods, no fresh food, shorten their lunch periods. Let's make sure that they won't get enough to eat to even be able to, take a test or, you know, their little minds, they need food. They need real food. I mean, it's like they want them all to fail and just be drones here. If you're not, I mean, it's proven. If you do not eat decent food, you will fail tests. And anybody that has children or grandchildren should be looking up the LA school district and asking questions, calling the Department of Education, calling the California Senate Office of Oversight and Outcomes. I would be calling all of these people and asking a lot of questions. And if you're in one of these counties that is under investigation right now, you should be like seriously taking a look at this. Because this isn't going to affect just children that are low income. This will affect all kids, especially if they're cutting back on the maintenance, probably the sanitation of the lunchroom, and they're cutting back on the amount of time that they give them to sit down and eat a good meal. I mean, this is just barbaric. Shameful. Shame. Shame on you people. This is where the word karma comes in. As always, God bless.